Then, of course, you know, Jay, at the end, he comes in, listen to the record. He sat down at the board. Song went off, he said.
Shit. I think we got one here, man.
Damn, N.O. Joe.
What up, y'all? It's N.O. Joe. I did records like this.
They claim we threats to society.
And this. But we're not here to talk about that right now. We're here to talk about one of my favorites. One of the first songs that came out, man, that kind of changed the rap game. And that's Never Seen a Man Cry.
I never understood why. I can never see a man cry till I seen a man die.
So here's the breakdown on it. All right, so I actually reprogrammed the whole song in Logic. So you kind of really kind of get a real breakdown of it. You know, it was a collaborative effort, but I'm going to let you hear, like, the drum sounds and stuff are made for it and some of the atmospheric stuff that, had in the background of the song. And, the song actually, Face and Mike brought in the bass line, the vocal. It's like a monotone vocal and the chords. And I actually dumped the MIDI stuff over into my MPC. They actually did it in ASR-10. It was like a pretty much straight beat. But I heard a lot of stuff when I heard the rough of it. I heard the finished product, you know. But I didn't want to be that cocky and say I had a finished product, you know, because I'm just really kind of working with them at the time. We dumped everything over into my drum machine. It's the MPC, the first MPC, the one with the armrests on it. You know what I'm saying? That's how long I've been in the game. So, I like to start off the songs with like a kick. So the kicks were, this kick, all of the drum sounds, like the kick, let's see. Kick is, man. All of these sounds were like, they were basically, they were EQ'd and compressed and everything in like SSLs and Neves. That's where before I came to rap a lot, I was out at Chung King Studio working under Universal Records. And they booked the studio for me, so I was able to, like, you know, make my sounds super strong. And really, like, never knowing that I would, you know, be working with, like, Ghetto Boys and Scarface and UGK and, you know, all of these acts, I never thought, like, these records would be placed, here.
But I never will forget that day we recorded this. And it was really cold in the studio, and I was really, really high, and it was really, really dark, and all I could see was Mike Dean and Joe sitting in front of the board, right?
So this kick started off with the kick here, so let's see.
Damn, N.O. Joe, like that?
It had like a swing to it, you know? Basically, the style that I brought to the game was more of a kind of gangster swing, like basically the New Jack Swing slowed down, gangstified. So that's what it was. So we had the kick here, kick, and the snare. Then I layered that with like a clap right under it, and a regular little hi-hat. Then to give the snare and the clap a little to it, I put like a rim shot. So then we had to add the little sizzle on the top of it, which gave it like his layer over the top of the hat. So, but then I gave another sizzle to it, right? So that gave it that sizzle. But then I added this bell in there, like a jingle bell. But the way I toned it and everything was more like, man, it was, I just made it weird. So, you know, it's different than a jingle bell, like a sleigh bell or whatever. So then we had the loop, which is the loop I actually, the loop I made in MPC. Then I had this rolling cymbal at the top of the record that went like this here. Right? 808 crash. Then we had the 808 crash, which was this. Alright. So slapstick, that slapstick was something I made. I got it out of I forgot what keyboard it was, but I stacked it with something else and made that weird as well. I never wanted to have sounds that people had in keyboards or anything like that. So, you know, in the producer community, it's kind of like, you know, hey man, yeah, he got that out of the Trinity, or that's the sound or whatever. I hated that. I didn't like that. So I wanted to do everything original. Then the bass line, of course. That boy bass. Then we had the piano. Piano is like, it's like a Rhodes, it's like an old Fender Rhodes that they used to use back in the days. And then the next thing added in there was the worm sound. Used to use it back in the 90s, like a melody. And of course we had the strings. It's like vintage type of strings we had again. And it's bringing back memories, man. So, then there was this sound, it's like a guitar sound that they used in like Peaches and Herb and the Reunited song, and I think one of Lenny Kravitz songs.
Get it right.
And I used to love that sound, and I researched it and seen what it was, and you know, that's something I wanted to use in this song, so, and that's this. I put like a flanger modulation on it. Of course, like this organ is like an Al Green organ. And I actually use it in, you know, produce Player Player.
Remember that shirt that she bought you on your birthday? I got two of those, a pair of pants and shoes on the first day. I'm just a player, y'all.
And that's why I introduced that organ at, the organs were samples from C-Saint Studios, which was where the Meters recorded. That was the same organ they had in there with Alan Toussaint was the producer. And I sampled that organ sound there, and I just kind of was messing with the draw bars and stuff. I didn't know what I was doing, but I knew a sound I wanted. So I think I sampled it like three or four times with different tones or whatever. But I sampled it on a cassette, note by note. Then I transferred it to DAC. Then I transferred it to CD. Then I transferred it into the DAW system. So that way I could go back to all of my old sounds that I used back in the 90s and use it with the plethora of like all of the millions of sounds they have now. It's like, you know, I'm born all over again. I love music. So we had the organ here. And that was pretty much the song, man. It was very simple, but it set a tone. It set a tone for music. And man, Face, like when he came in, it was time to redo the vocal. And so Face was like, I said, man, you need to like do it like a preacher. You know, he was like, what you mean? So I used to rap. Like he heard some stuff I rapped on, and I used to kind of mimic him. And, you know, he used to like it, you know, and so he had been trying to get me in the vocal booth for a long time. And he was like, well, you go in there and do it. And I was like, all right, I'll go in there and do it. So, you know, I went in there and it was just like, I just thought, you know, rapping his first lines, I didn't really know it. I was like, he greased his father with his hands out.
Rehabilitated slightly, glad to be the man's child. World was different since he seen it last. But out of jail, 7 years, pretty happy because it's free at last.
You know, but I was telling them, like, not as dramatic, but, you know, like the ups and downs of a preacher. And he was like, man, you want me to do that? I don't know, Joe. And I was like, just go try it. So he went in and he did it. And he went through with it and nailed it. I mean, nailed it. I was like, man, this dude actually really sounds like a preacher. And, man, he came out, but I don't think he was really that comfortable with it until I guess he took it in and everybody listened to it. And it was just like it's something special. And, you know, that was the song. So, man, you know, I really appreciated this song, like, from the beginning, man, when it was brought in, the whole vibe of the song just had a great tone to it. So I'm going to run it from the top here. Again, this is Reprogrammed all over again. Of course, Face, you got to come in and play the bass line. And, you know, Mike, you got to come in and play or whatever. But, like, these are a lot of the sounds I added to the track. It was a collaborative effort. Check it out. Wanted it to, like, it's basically just like the record because it's the actual sounds, you know? Hear that bell in there?
He greets his father with his hands up, rehabilitated slight, glad to be the man's child. The world is different since he's seen it last. Out of jail been 7 years, and he's happy that he's free at last. All he had was his mother's letter. Now he's mobile, and he's gotta make a change and make it for the better. But he's black, so he's got one strike against him. And he's young, plus he came up in the system. But he's smart, and he's finally making 18. And his goal's to get on top and try to stay clean. So he's calling up his homie who came up living nervous. Now they dealing with the same stuff and had that.
So, man, like this record, man, like there was another organ part that. I hummed that to Mike Dean, and I wanted him to play it on the organ, this organ patch I had there. And, man, you know, this record really, I love the record, but it resonated to me when my dad was on his deathbed. And my dad, I'd never seen him cry at all, man. He was just hard, like a Superman, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, he was on this deathbed, and we were talking to him, and he couldn't talk back to us. And, you know, I seen a tear coming down his eye. So I guess he was just like, man, I can't talk to y'all. And, you know, I thought about the record, and I'm like, man, it really hit home then, man. And so this record holds a special place in my heart. It holds a special place in my heart. The record holds a special place in my heart. And, but I will be giving you more breakdowns of records, you know, down the line here. You know, I produced the Diary album with Face, the Riding Dirty, all of your classic records. I'm the common denominator between those two records. Y'all stay tuned. Peace.
My cousin Jamal's going.
Oh, no, dog. He's trying to live it one day at a time, you know?
And he passed away here recently, so when I do this song, man, it kind of touched me a little bit because I miss my cousin.